greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. Thank you, Skeptic Owl, for your challenge. Romans 10:9 contradicts John 3:16. Greetings, brother. Let's examine your claim and see whether you are correct or simply uninformed or are being intentionally deceptive. First, let us examine what Romans 10:9 states, that if you confess with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. The phrase Jesus is Lord causes some people confusion. It means Jesus is God when we read it in context. Romans 10:12, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. This verse speaks of the one who is Lord over all. This Lord is clearly God, and this is confirmed in the next verse. Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This refers to prophet Joel, who said the following, Joel 2:32, and it will come about that whoever calls upon the name of the Lord, Yahweh, will be delivered. For on Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there will be those who escape, as the Lord has said, even among the survivors whom the Lord calls. And this was recited in Acts 2:21. Acts 2:21, and it shall be that whoever calls on the name of the Lord, meaning Yahweh, will be saved. So for you to believe that Jesus is Lord means you must believe Jesus is Yahweh. Now let's look, brother, at what John 3:16 states. For God so loved the world that he gave the only begotten Son, so that everyone believing in him should not perish, but should have eternal life. You claim Romans 10:9 contradicts John 3:16. I take that to mean you assert the following. John 3:16 says we must believe in him to be saved, while Romans 10:9 says we must believe God raised Jesus from the dead to be saved. The very word contradiction is comprised of two parts, contra, meaning against or opposite to, diction, meaning choice and use of words in speaking or writing. A contradiction is stating an exact opposite, whereby one or the other can be true, but both cannot be true. An example of this is the case where Surah 5:14 of the Quran contradicts Surah 4:157 of the Quran. Both cannot be true. In the case of John 3:16, the phrase believe in him does not specify any details. Does believe in him mean, one, you must believe Jesus existed as a historical figure? Some deny he even existed. Or does believe in him mean, two, you must believe Jesus was a prophet of Yahweh? Some doubt Jesus was a prophet. Some doubt Yahweh God even exists, that he might send prophets. Does believe in him mean, three, you must believe the things Jesus said? Jesus declared he was the Son of God. Some doubt Jesus said this. Some claim Jesus' words have been lost or changed. Does believe in him mean you must believe Jesus is the Son of God? Some doubt God has a son and claim God needs no son. But Jesus said he was the Son of God and called Yahweh God his Father. Does believe in him mean, five, you must believe Jesus was the Messiah? Many doubt Jesus was the Messiah because he did not come as conquering king. Islam accepts the word Messiah, but does not understand what Messiah implies. Does believe in him mean, six, you must believe Jesus was crucified and died on the cross? A whole religion was created by a man to deny this. Does believe in him mean, seven, You must believe Jesus rose from the dead as the prophets foretold. The religion that denies his death also necessarily denies his resurrection. But the disciples of Jesus who saw Jesus die also saw Jesus after his death, alive, walking and talking and eating with them, and none of them ever denied these facts, even when tortured and put to death. Does believe in him mean 8, you must believe Jesus is God, come in the flesh, fulfilling the prophets? There are many details of Jesus, the Messiah, the Son of God, which we must believe, brother. I have tried to list these in order of dependency. You cannot believe 2 unless you also believe 1. You cannot believe Jesus was a prophet unless you first believe Jesus existed. You cannot believe number 7, that God raised Jesus from the dead, without believing the previous 6. And there may be additional details which could be identified, but these are sufficient to discuss your claim. Some atheists doubt number 1, meaning they doubt that a man named Jesus ever actually lived. Some atheists believe number 1. They believe a man named Jesus actually lived and was killed by the Romans. Do we think that some atheists who believe number 1 will be saved for believing Jesus existed? No. That means we think believing Jesus existed is not what believing in Jesus means. So some atheists believe number 1. They believe a man named Jesus actually lived and was killed by the Romans. But they doubt Jesus rose from the dead. They will not be saved, brother. People called Muslims believe 1 and 2. They make the claim Jesus existed and was a prophet, but they do not believe what Jesus said, brother. Their religion, your religion, teaches you to claim you respect what Jesus said, but deny any record exists of what Jesus actually said, outside the Quran. They will not be saved, brother, because they deny what Jesus said about himself. So John 3:16 establishes that through Jesus, or by Jesus, we should be saved, but should is not an absolute word. It is a word of possibility and potential. You should drive your car safely, but not all drivers are safe drivers. You should be saved by knowing the truth about Jesus, but not all wish to hear and obey the truth. Romans 10:9 provides the conclusive details, brother. You must believe these 2 ultimate assertions to possess the salvation which Jesus made possible. Romans 10:9 clarifies with certainty that you will be saved if you believe these 2 ultimate things. You must believe Jesus is Lord, meaning Jesus is God, and Jesus was raised from the dead. These were items 7 and 8 in the list above, and you cannot believe 7 and 8 unless you also first believe 6 and 5 and 4 and 3 and 2 and 1. And that would include any other earlier dependencies I simply did not happen to identify. There is no contradiction, brother. You are simply uninformed of the message of the true Injil. I also do not believe you are intentionally deceptive, brother. I think you are sincere and honest in your zeal to defend the message you are committed to. You have been taught and trained to attack the Torah and Bible. That is not an unforgivable sin, brother. But brother, if you refuse to believe in Jesus, refuse to believe that Jesus is Lord, and that Jesus rose from the dead, you will condemn yourself. Be condemned by your own choice. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.